What are you holding on to? Let it go. Let me tell you a story. There was this young man called Kojo, living in a town called Mepeyasem. Everybody know that he doesn't believe there is a supreme being called God, but the world came by itself, including various religious groups in the town. The profession of Kojo is parrot hunting in deep forest on very high trees. So one day when he went about doing his job in the deep forest, he had already climbed one very tall tree and about to catch one bird. Then the branch on which he sat on broke and he started falling down from the tree. Then fortune smiled at him. He got hold of a branch as he nearly got to the ground, which will lead to his death. But as he was falling off the tree, he was shouting, "Lord, Lord, save me," several times. Then he got that bench to hold on to. Then he said, "God, if you exist as people are saying, save me." And all of a sudden he heard an audible voice in his ears. "If you believe I exist, leave the branch." He was amazed and surprised. Then he let go of the branch and within seconds he sat on the ground. The question is, what are you holding on to that's keeping from believing there is a supreme, almighty, I am that I am, Yahweh, Lord of Lord, everlasting God? Is it earthly things, chasing after girls, the love of money and power, or pride? What's holding you back? My brother, my sister, let it or them go. They are not wealth, they are all vanity, and they all have an end. But for God's love is everlasting. That's why he let his begotten son came to die a shameful dead for you and I. Don't let some vanity things hold you from an everlasting peace, joy, and happiness. John 3:16. For God so greatly loved and dearly prized the world, that he even gave his one and only begotten Son, so that whoever believes and trusts in him as Saviour shall not perish, but have eternal life. But the verse 17 says, "For God did not send the Son into the world to judge and condemn the world, that is, to initiate the final judgment of the world, but that the world might be saved through him." Please understand that sinful addictions are sometimes sweet and will call you for more than locking you down in your sinful nature. But I have good news for you. If you resist the devil and run from your addictive sins, the Lord is merciful and kind to take you as you are, will forgive you of all your sins and wash of all your unclean sins. Verse 18 says, "Whoever believes and has decided to trust in him as personal Savior and Lord is not judged for this one. There is no judgment, no rejection, no condemnation. But the one who does not believe and has decided to reject him as personal Savior and Lord is judged already, that one has been convicted and sentenced, because he has not believed and trusted in the name of the one and only begotten Son of God, the one who is truly unique, the only one of his kind, the one who alone can save him. The most serious part is that you reject, you are in danger, as verse 19 to 20 says, 19. This is the judgment, that is, the cause for indictment, the test by which people are judged, the basis for the sentence. The light has come into the world, and people loved the darkness rather than the light, for their deeds were evil. 20. For every wrongdoer hates the light, and does not come to the light, but shrinks from it, for fear that his sinful, worthless activities will be exposed and condemned. Hallelujah pays the Lord. But verse 21 says, "But whoever practices truth and does what is right, morally, ethically, spiritually, comes to the light, so that his works may be plainly shown to be what they are, accomplished in God, divinely prompted, done with God's help, in dependence on him." Let me add Romans 8, 1-2. Escape from bondage 1. Therefore there is now no condemnation, no guilty verdict, no punishment for those who are in Christ Jesus, who believe in him as personal Lord and Savior. Romans 10, 9, NIV. If you declare with your mouth, "Jesus is Lord," and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. My brother, my sister, a word to the wise is enough. Come to the light. Stop holding on to vanity and addictive sins, and enjoy eternity with the Lord our God. Hold on, another thing you need to do. Matthew 6:15, NIV. But if you do not forgive others their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins. Forgiveness is key to salvation and heaven. You need to let go of all that is holding you back. Forgive others of their sins against you so that yours will be forgiven. King Solomon sum it all up for us. Now all has been heard. Here is the conclusion of the matter. Fear God and keep His commandments, for this is the duty of all mankind. For God will bring every deed into judgment, including every hidden thing, whether it is good or evil. Let's pray. Lord, have preached your word to your people. Please save whoever is watching this video in Jesus' name. Amen.